In a show of unity, Mayor Fry, Governor Walz, and other state and local leaders spoke late last night.
This is one of those incidents should be unthinkable, but it's very thinkable because it's now happened four times in the last couple months.
We got to do everything possible to make sure that these tragic events, this epidemic of gun violence, this kind of stuff never happens again.
An emotional scene in the last 10 hours as Jamal Mitchell's body was taken to the medical examiner's office in Minnetonka. The miles-long procession included hundreds of officers honoring the ultimate sacrifice that Officer Mitchell made. In the last few hours, we've learned more about who Jamal Mitchell is and his legacy now living on after his death. Audrey is live in the medical examiner's office where Officer Mitchell's body was taken just hours ago. Audrey.
Yeah, Jason, oftentimes in these situations, we hear the phrase, he ran towards the danger rather than away from it. And we're learning that Officer Jamal Mitchell has pretty much been doing that since his first few days on the job. We're learning he's only been a Minneapolis police officer for around a year and a half. We learned that last February, Officer Mitchell ran into a burning building with no fire training on his third day on the job to rescue an elderly couple. Assistant Police Chief Katie Blackwell talking about this heroic act at a press conference just a few hours ago. She said that that level of courage, for which she was awarded and commended, is rare to find in an officer so early in their career.
To our fallen officer, Jamal Mitchell, he was a hero. I've never met an officer that received an award on the third day on the job during his FTO. He's courageous in every action that he did. He was a wonderful human being. Yeah.
Now, Officer Mitchell leaves behind a fiance and a child. As you drive by state office buildings this morning, you may notice that the flags have been lowered to half staff. That was a directive that was issued overnight by Governor Walz in Officer Mitchell's honor, describing him as a dedicated public servant. Coming up in the next half hour, we'll hear more from the mayor of the city of Minneapolis about how he's promising to honor this fallen officer.